With Brexit around the corner, living abroad might be fraught with uncertainties. But even with a falling pound, it can still make financial sense. And not just because of cheaper property prices overseas, but the rise of the budget airline. Amazingly, it is often cheaper to fly to another country than to take a train between cities. So, for example, my flight today to Toulouse is costing £33.30. A single train ticket from Portsmouth to London, £35.30. Now, airports can be a painful place to be, but with a bit of forethought and hand luggage, I reckon I could be taking off in 40 minutes. The journey to Toulouse in southwest France starts with a 30-minute Gatwick Express train. The flight takes an hour and 40, and from there it's another 40 minutes drive to the stunning village of Beauville. Total travel time, 4 hours, just an hour longer than Liam's. 8 years ago, fashion stylist Karen Foster, husband Will Laws, and her daughters Maddie and Tilly made a massive decision, moving from their home in West Sussex to a new life in the south of France. But not everything was new. Karen still had to work in London in the week, meaning a commute every Monday morning.
Okay, I think this is us. Look at this.
Wow. Hello. Hello.
Hello there.
I have a feeling from the sound of your voices, I'm in the right place.
Thank goodness.
You found us. I found you. Hello.
Karen and Will spent just over £1 million on this 12-bedroom, 15th-century chateau and its 20 acres of land. They've worked hard to transform it from its former run-down, tired state into a gorgeous living home, all under Karen's expert designer eye.
Now, clearly, it seems like a ridiculous question to be sat here on a lovely sunny evening eating this food. But what does living here give you that life in England didn't?
It's a hard question because we actually had a really lovely life in England.
I just fell in love with this village, the whole feel, the atmosphere. We have a much quieter pace. There was always people, always things to do, always pressures. And here, we literally are in our little bubble here. We do more family things. Mm. We play cards. It's not so much about computers, about keeping up with everybody.
How did you find integrating to the local community?
The community is amazing. They've been so welcoming, friendly.
I mean, did you speak French before you came
not
here?
Not a word not between us. Not a word.
That's brave, huh?
And that does raise another consideration when moving abroad with a family, the children's education.
So you guys are both at school in England,
yes.
And before you knew it, you're sort of uprooted and dropped in France.
Yes, we went to completely French schools with no one speaking English, and that was first was very, very hard. I think it took about 6 months to really like understand what people were saying, and then we became fluent, I think, about 2 years after we arrived, so it didn't take too long.
Maddie was 10 when the family moved to France, important because studies have shown that after the age of 11, learning a language becomes much more difficult. As for me, this commuting malarkey has tired me out.
Well, look, I'll see you in the morning, guys. Thank you very much.
Charlie.
See you tomorrow.
Happy dreams. All
cheers.
Best. Cheers.
Cheers, guys. Thank you.
After a good night's sleep, the charm of chateau life is still easy to appreciate.
Now, this certainly feels like a little bit of French heaven, but I'm interested to find out what kind of sacrifices and compromises you've got to make to live in a place like this, especially for Karen. Because remember, she still commutes to and works in London. Good morning. Right.
Off to the market, Charlie.
Give it some welly. That's it.
Karen's now a freelance stylist, so has more irregular work than she did when she moved here. But I still want to know how difficult it is to work in one country and live in another.
How do you work with England and France?
I'm flying back maybe on a Monday morning, early morning, then back on a Friday.
How much does that cost, all of that travel?
Well, because I'm freelance now, it is a little bit more, but it's still less than my train fare when I lived in West Sussex, but 2 hours door-to-door commute, that was about £8,000 a year. And now it must be around £5,000 a year.
Okay, so it's cheaper.
It's cheaper,
What about the family? I mean, I travel quite a lot for work, and my kids and wife are very stoic, but I know they're not ecstatic about it. Yeah. How about your family?
I don't know. I always have worked and travelled, especially the travel, ever since the children were little. Mm. And I think they've just got completely used to it. They've always said, Mummy, you're so much happier when you're busy. I'm not good at sitting still.
For a lot of us, a stumbling block to moving abroad would be our partner's career. But Will's skills as a landscape architect are transferable, meaning he was able to find work locally. But with Brexit looming, his job and their lifestyle might be under threat.
How do you feel now that there is all of this uncertainty around Europe?
I think at the end of the day, what will be. Nothing's been set in stone.
We love it here. Nothing's going to change us.
But your relationship of going back to work in England, that might become more problematic.
Yes, well, maybe I become a French dual residency or...
So you might become French.
Well, we're not going to give up our citizenship in England just yet.
The couple have also created another income source. They spent 9 months doing up 3 outbuildings on the property, which they now rent out as holiday cottages. Or as they say in France, gîtes.
Now the gîtes are up and running and you work locally, does that not provide you with a pretty decent income so that you could actually not have to go back to work in the UK?
We could survive on the income from the gîtes now, whereas at the beginning it was pretty hard, wasn't it?
But your job is your passion as well.
Yeah,
it's not just a job.
It's not just a job, you know.
It's a lifestyle choice.
It's
you love it.
I love it with an absolute passion. I would find it hard to give it up. I think it's got to come to an end naturally.
If I wanted to buy a house for £500,000, could I get an element of this lifestyle?
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Absolutely.
No problem. It's a lot out there.
There's so much out there available.
And you get a lot for your money.
And you get a lot for your money.